think fostering new forms of collaboration while still respecting the business units as they are is kind of one of those key questions within digital transformation. For us, one of the ways that we look at doing that is by infusing new rituals into the company. For us, a ritual is a routine practice that rewires a mindset and actually has you behaving habitually in a different way. So rather than thinking conceptually with posters in the room, you literally say, we're going to re-architect the way a meeting might happen. There's some rituals, for example, that I love. Amazon has a two pizza rule, which is like, we can't have teams that take more than two pizzas to feed, because that form of team structure is the right size of the team. Another senior executive we worked with had a ritual where he erased all standing meetings. No, you have to have an intent for a meeting, and that gets scheduled on an as-needed basis. I will no longer take scheduled meetings. So looking into how does the organization communicate on a regular basis, and what are the rituals that govern that, and going in and literally retuning those rituals to get the outcomes we want, get people to speak a little bit more frequently together, bring, let's say, legal and IT into the conversation at critical moments that are earlier than they might normally appear. Those interventions, I would say, are really critical. Some of the ways that I've seen it done right, the first would be leadership commitment. In almost all of these companies, if top leadership is not willing to, let's say, adopt a similar tool set, but it's just delegated down, or to run a meeting in a different way that's a little bit more inclusive or fosters more diversity of opinion, which is always so critical. If those leaders don't adopt those behaviors themselves, it's one of the first symptoms that things will not go well, or one of the first symptoms that things will go well. So I think the leadership buy-in and actual adoption of different behaviors and ways of working is probably the most critical thing that I've seen work. The other, which is again a leadership attribute, which is lowering the threshold for experimentation. I'm not going to talk about failure because I'm not a big advocate in failing. But I do believe that allowing companies to prototype and iterate on solutions and move towards a goal in smaller steps, but also be willing to learn from those steps being the wrong ones, that's a critical way of operating, because the journey towards whatever digital transformation end state you're seeking is not going to be linear and straightforward. So companies have to start learning how to adapt a little bit faster and tolerate a little bit more experimentation. And those two stand out for me at the moment.